going up.
Today, entrepreneurs looking to uplift their lives must prove to our elite panel of investors that they have what it takes in 60 seconds or less.
Wow.
That will never work.
Oh, boom.
This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business. Today in the boardroom, Kim Perell, CEO of 100.co. Marc Randolph, co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. Gary Swart, a Polaris partner and serial entrepreneur. Kicking off, an entrepreneur with a new nootropic beverage designed to boost brain power and focus.
Going up. Hello, Jasmine. Welcome to the elevator. Your pitch begins in 3, 2, 1.
My name is Jasmine Mooney, and I'm co-founder of Holy Water. We are an innovative PhD-led company that creates beverages using functional mushrooms, adaptogens, nootropics, and ketones that provide healthy alternatives for different use occasions throughout your day that foster longevity and a higher quality of life. Ketones are this incredible ingredient that puts your body into ketosis without having to fast, creating the ultimate source of fuel for your brain and your body. We launched 6 months ago with D2C and just launched into retail last month. We've done 400,000 in sales and are projected to end the year with 2 million. We are asking for $425,000 for 5% of our company, making that an 8.5 million valuation. This is the holy grail of holistic health, and we are looking for strategic partners like yourselves to take this to the next level and help us make this world a healthier, stronger, and happier place.
Wow, just got it in under the wire.
Yeah, I thought you did a great pitch.
So I'm curious to see, what is it about a mushroom and why can't I just eat mushrooms?
Mushrooms is a big category. Regular viewers of Elevator Pitch know that I did make an investment in a mushroom supplement company, so I kind of believe in the space.
All right, Kim, you're the CPG expert, and Mark, you know mushrooms. What do you say we vote?
Let's vote.
Attention, Jasmine. Your pitch has been approved.
Okay. Hi.
Hi, welcome, Jasmine. Great energy on your pitch, and you threw a lot of buzzwords in there.
I mean, I thought you did a great pitch. You had a lot of information in there, but I didn't understand what a ketone is.
You have ketones. You all have ketones in your body. They're already there. It's when you fast, you go into ketosis. So this is an ingredient called a ketone ester. It's called R13-butanediol that puts your body into ketosis. So you're getting all of those benefits without having to fast by just drinking our beverage.
Can we try it?
Absolutely. So this is ketones completely on its own.
Oh, great. We're having the really crappy thing first. So yours tastes great afterwards?
Yeah, it's pure. This is straight ketones.
Bottoms up.
Bottoms up. Cheers.
Cheers, guys. I need a chaser for that ketone.
That does not taste good.
Ugh.
The reason I wanted you to try that ingredient is so you understand what we're working with and how my doctor has masked the taste of holy water.
Anything has to taste better than what I just had.
I think that was a brilliant tactic.
Yeah.
Something that tastes ghastly so that we have this and we think it tastes great.
I'm gonna have one with you, too.
Well, that's significantly better than the ketone.
It is.
That actually tastes pretty good.
Yeah.
So what's with the name?
To us, it's not about religion. My doctor is very passionate about language. Holy means sacred, and to him, health is sacred.
How do you reach customers?
Every single day, I do an event in health and wellness. I will not do anything unless I get to bring my cooler of holy water around everywhere with me.
I love your grassroots marketing, but in order for this to be truly successful, you're gonna need a lot more capital in order to expand. So how much are you actually raising right now?
4 million.
I actually like the direction you're going. The challenge is, I don't know the business that well. So this is one of those ones where if Kim is out, well, then I'd be out. And if you are in, I'm probably gonna try and steal it from you.
Well, here's the good news. I'm out. I think you're a great spokesperson. The product tastes good, but I don't know mushrooms and I don't know CPG like Kim, so I just think they're better suited.
I think you are a great founder, but I also know how hard CPG beverage is and how much capital you're going to have to raise.
Yes.
So unfortunately, until you get more traction, I'm going to pass.
This business is so dependent on execution, and I don't know how well you guys are going to do yet. It is too early. Reluctantly, I'm going to have to pass as well. Sorry we're sending you home.
No, don't be sorry at all.
Empty-handed.
Thank you
but
so much.
Best of luck with everything.
Okay, good luck.
Bye. Thanks, Jasmine.
And the feedback has been so incredible. Unfortunately, they couldn't feel the benefits of this quite yet, but I'm hoping one day they'll look back and be like, shoot.
You've got to come in here not just saying, I've got a great product that tastes good. You've got to say, I understand what I'm doing, and here's evidence that I know how to actually make this thing move offshore.
Well, I like what Kim said about the amount of capital that they were going to need to really reach the market.
From my experience, if you could just get this drink in and nail the market, you could always scale.
Media, enterprise, and government websites worldwide trust WordPress VIP to run, grow, and secure their websites.
When you're making a pitch, I want you to tell it, not sell it. I'm not your customer. I'm an investor. I want to know how that's going to make my investment profitable. And most importantly, I'm looking to see that you have the chops to make your business work.
Next up, we have an entrepreneur with a groundbreaking web application designed to help individuals with special needs build meaningful connections.
My name is Juliana Fetherman, and I created Making Authentic Friendships. This is Michael. He has autism and ADHD, and he inspired this initiative. Throughout high school and college, I saw that my brother didn't really have plans on the weekends, people to be with, things to do the way I did. So I decided I wanted to create something to help him and individuals like him find people with similar interests. So I created this.
Hello, Juliana and Michael. Welcome to the elevator. Your pitch begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Juliana Fetherman, and I created Making Authentic Friendships, an app that enables individuals with special needs to make friends based on their age, interest, diagnosis, and location. Making Authentic Friendships, MAF, are also my brother's initials. This is my brother, Michael, and he's 26, and he has autism and ADHD. Growing up, he always struggled with social skills and making and keeping friends, like so many individuals with special needs do. So I created this for him and the millions of others like him. We don't only serve autism, although majority of our users do have autism. We serve over 20 different diagnoses, both intellectual and physical disabilities. We currently serve over 8,000 users in all 50 states and 75 countries. It works like a game. You create an avatar that looks like yourself and can earn coins. And we are asking for $200,000 for 20% equity to turn our 8,000 users into 80,000. And which one of you wants to join us and help us make the world a better place?
Oh my gosh, I actually love what she's created. I guess the question that I have is, how big is the market?
Yeah, I agree. I mean, that story is heartwarming. You can tell she's got a great relationship with her brother, but is there a business here? That's the question.
You know, sometimes you can make investments that are out of your heart, but other times you've got to make it out of your bank account.
Sometimes you make it out of your heart and it actually pays off.
Maybe this is going to be one of those ones for you, Kim.
Attention, Juliana and Michael. Your pitch has been denied.
Okay, buddy.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I mean, guys, that was gut-wrenching. Honestly, I wanted to send her up, but there were so many questions that I still had.
Yeah, you know, I kind of feel like I need to wash my hands. I kind of feel dirty for having voted them down.
I think you should. Kim, you wanted to hear more. Why not let him in and hear more?
This, to me, feels like something that I would invest in as a nonprofit, and I do a lot of investing like that.
Well, I think this could have been an opportunity to do well by doing good.
Feeling pretty good. Very excited that we got the opportunity, and hopefully the exposure will help us reach more users and more families.
I say, let's bring her into the boardroom. Let's ask a couple of questions, just hear a little bit more about her business. Maybe there's something we can do to be helpful that's not $200,000.
I'd be down for that.
It's good to give people a second chance, so let's try it.
Sometimes you might need a personal time.
Attention, Juliana and Michael. Your presence has been requested back in the boardroom.
All right, back to the elevator.
Hi.
Hi, Juliana and Michael.
So good to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you as well. We just wanted to ask you a couple more questions about your business.
Absolutely, I would love that.
So give me a sense, is there a real business here?
That's a very valid concern, one that isn't uncommon. My belief is that we can make the world a better place and also have a business, you know, make that profit. We do run on a subscription base and we're not at a point where we're necessarily profitable yet, but if we can build our database big enough, it definitely is a possibility where we can be making the money and it's mutually beneficial.
How much revenue are you making on a monthly basis?
Like $30,000 a year from the app alone. It's that, and it's really just at a point now where I'm making enough to keep up with it, but not much more. And that's really why we need an investor to kind of scale it and take it to that next level. I mean, I've been doing this alone for like 5 years. I was in college. $1,000 was a lot of money to me then.
So
I can't,
Juliana,
scale it without investment.
Let me just ask my colleagues quickly here. I have an idea, and I think we're in agreement. I don't think that we're at a point where we would invest $200,000 in your business, which was your ask. But on behalf of Amazon Business, we would like to gift you $10,000 in order to help accelerate your business.
Wow, that would be so amazing. Thank you so much. I so appreciate that. Hey, buddy, can you say thank you?
Oh,
thank you.
So nice to meet you.
So nice to meet you.
You're doing really important work.
Thank you so much.
Michael, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Good luck with it.
Nice to meet you. Pleasure. Michael, say thank you so much. Thank you. Yay, nice, buddy. Good job.
I'm really glad that we got to ask those few questions and clarify that they do have some revenue, but not enough. But I feel really good that Amazon was generous enough to do that.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business. For every organization at every stage of growth. Next in the elevator, a returning pair of entrepreneurs with a revolutionary app that transforms learning musical instruments into a game-changing adventure.
Going up. Hello, Stephen and Aspen. Welcome to the elevator. Your pitch begins in 3, 2, 1.
3 months ago, we pitched you our first idea, making video games that help students learn music. We took your feedback and we pivoted into an even stronger company. We taught in person with teachers and we learned that they are ravenous for new ways to engage their students. We also found that our games were especially useful in the classroom when used socially, when students played together. So we recreated Overture Games as a platform of lessons and video games that teachers can use in the classroom with their students to engage them socially.
While most edtech companies take up to 1 year to close their first school contract, we got 3 deals in just a matter of 3 months, plus one partnership giving us access to 30 additional locations in our pipeline for this fall. With 120,000 K-12 schools in the US, our goal is to expand our product beyond music into other core subjects. Today, we're seeking $200,000 for 3% of our company. Let's chat and change the future of education together.
Ooh, wow.
I love that they pivoted. Every great entrepreneur I know has pivoted. That's pretty impressive.
Just the fact that they pivoted does not mean they've landed on a winner.
Well, some people tell entrepreneurs that will never work. here's a case where it actually could work.
It is just so challenging trying to sell to schools. I love that they pivoted, but I hope they haven't set themselves up for a struggle.
Consumer businesses can be even harder, though. And I do have experience in a music education software company that sold to Microsoft for $100 million.
Oh, boom!
But listen, the only way we're going to find out whether we even get that opportunity, Gary, is if we put it to a vote.
Let's do it, compadre.
Attention, Stephen and Aspen. Your pitch has been approved.
Let's go.
Aspen and Stephen, welcome to the boardroom. Congratulations. It isn't often that people get a second bite at the apple here. What's the big change between what you presented to us previously and what you're presenting to us today?
Yeah, so just 3 months ago, we're actually building a consumer app and going direct to consumers with a video game that helps solve practice burnout. And then we actually took your feedback seriously, Mark, because it's actually a very hard problem to solve. And we realized that in group setting, our game works fantastically. We got a lot of word-of-mouth intros from schools, after-school program directors.
So you pivoted because selling to consumers is hard. Have you tried selling to school systems? That could be even harder.
So we also realized the challenge, but I think we got some secret sauce here. We partner with channel partners that directly have access to many, many different schools at the same time. That's how we're able to get into the school system that fast in just 3 months.
Is there any way to see how it works?
Let's pull up the game.
So I'm gonna grab my clarinet here with me.
It's my dad's birthday. So we're gonna sing happy birthday, and we're gonna learn the notes to happy birthday by singing together. So this is the cat. The cat is going to move on the screen, and we're going to move based on the notes that we're seeing. So it uses pitch detection. If we mess up, the cat will hit the cave wall and restart. So it's a full video game, but you're learning music while you do it.
Happy birthday, to you. Happy birthday.
His name's Royce.
Dear Royce.
Oh, that's fantastic.
I mean, I love that you guys were not afraid to pivot. But again, I'm here to make money. So the question I have is, how much revenue have you made? And how much are your projections for next year? Because your valuation is quite high.
So we actually currently have over $5,000 recurring revenue from those three contracts we got.
$5,000 annual recurring
revenue.
That's
correct.
I love what you guys are doing. I love that you pivoted. I love that you're trying to find the market. Your high valuation just doesn't seem to match. So unfortunately, I'm going to pass.
Clearly, you guys are impressive. You took feedback well and pivoted. PowerPoint, you've got a good story arc. The Excel is where it falls short for me. I'd like to see a little bit more traction, and selling to schools and consumers is hard. And I'd like to see a little bit more evidence of product market fit there. But I certainly applaud you and appreciate the serenade. So I'm also a pass. Thank you.
So I'm a little scared about the advice I gave you last time. But if my advice was steering you into selling to schools and that being a path to success and profitability, I apologize. It's possible, but brutal. And so unfortunately, I'm afraid I have to pass.
You guys have done a great job in getting to where you're at. You just need more traction in market for one of us to invest.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you for your time. Thank you very much.
Good luck.
I think we did a really good job this time, way better than last time. We actually went through the elevator to meet the investors.
We'll just keep working at it, keep grinding, and that's what it's all about.
Based on the fact that they may have pivoted based on my advice, that scares me a little bit. What do I know?
Mark, don't be too hard on yourself. I often tell entrepreneurs, don't take my advice. I encourage them to get other opinions.
And not being afraid to pivot.
A considerably lower valuation would help too.
Tune in next week as Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch continues.
How can you say that without telling me your revenue?
They left the field before the clock had run out.
You don't always have to use it all the time.